Hello everyone, welcome back for more Let's Play Star Wars The Old Republic. Last we left off, we were killing gangsters and, well, mercenary merchants, so to speak. So let's keep that up, shall we? Seems like more something that would be, you know, what you would hope for in, you know, the police force, but apparently we can't do that because we have bigger fish to fry. Hey, if they just give me the clearance, I'd go ahead and take care of the entire mercenaries, gangs, and Black Suns, and all that. I'd just get rid of it all for them. I mean, I've got an assault cannon strapped to my back.
Now, are we leaving or not?
As soon as you sign this waiver, sir.
Wow, that conversation keeps popping in and out on me, doesn't it? But I've got an assault cannon strapped to my back. I think I can make a difference in, well, you know, a gang or two. Well, it already sounds like the fighting's kicked up a notch around here. See, is there an easy way down? Doesn't really look like it. Looks like I'm gonna have to take the elevators. I could probably make that jump. And not die horribly. Probably. Really? Right here, huh?
Banana.
Slightly higher level group, huh? Are you smiling? Nope, screaming silently. Okay. Yep, that's a typical reaction to meeting me. Go. No loot, huh? Just a scavenging node. Oh well. We'll get more.
You better stay sharp down here.
I doubt the Black Sun is very welcoming toward authority figures.
I see it. How do I get to it? To come all the way around? Looks like it. Hmm. many, many nodes.
Do this.
That one. Go over here and pick this one up. These guys are carrying loot. That's disappointing. I really need to go find a trainer on this planet. Of course, I can't remember where they are.
Sir, fine. I'll handle it.
Good. Scan that. Nothing? Stingy, stingy people. So where do I need to be going? Not this way.
Take them down.
You guys are definitely quicker to come after me. Yep. Sorry about that. Now, what's the best way to go from here? Don't think I can climb over that. You're just kind of an outlaw, huh? Nope. No easy way back up that I can see. Hey, could you pull me up after you? No. Darn you. The one time you could have been really useful.
Up and at him.
They're robbing me of loot. Like, a lot of it. Scavenging.
Report your ailments.
Build the junk, repair all.
You are fit for duty. Return to your post.
Need to go that way, but there's a node over here. Along with some undesirables, we will call them. There we go. I definitely need to go see a trainer. I definitely need to go get this node. Scavenging and slicing seem to be leveling up fairly evenly. Okay, Jaxo. Better have good news for me.
Hey there, you must be the new Havoc CO. I'm Jaxo, it's good to meet you.
I expect a salute.
Is that how you greet a superior officer, Sergeant Jaxo?
No offense, but I'm undercover, and military etiquette doesn't really fit in with these people. And speaking of these people, your highly enviable task is to destroy a cache of nerve gas canisters that the Black Sun Syndicate is shipping to Tavis. The gas is called Travoris. Scary stuff. One canister can cover a square kilometer with 100% fatality inside of 10 minutes.
How do we destroy it?
Do we have any way to safely deal with this stuff?
Lucky for us, it's pretty easy to neutralize Travoris, at least while it's still in the canisters. The compound in this bottle renders Travoris completely inert on contact. Just plug it into the canisters inside the Black Sun base, and the whole batch is history.
Anything we need to do with the canisters themselves?
Should I just leave the neutralized gas behind?
Once the Travoris is neutralized, it's useless. No need to retrieve it. General Garza said not to bother. You also have another objective. A few hours ago, a bright red case was moved into the Black Sun's base under heavy guard. If whatever's inside that case is valuable to Black Sun, it's bad news for us. So your job will be to find the case and bring me its contents.
This'll be easy.
I can do this in my sleep. Maybe I will.
One last detail. Black Sun has signal jammers throughout their base, so General Garza won't know to send help if you get in over your head.
I never liked being watched.
Its constant surveillance was getting on my nerves anyway.
You should enjoy it while you can. I never get that kind of support on my ops. Once you've taken care of the Travoris canisters and nabbed whatever's inside that red case, be sure to meet me back here to confirm the mission results. Good luck, Lieutenant.
Okay. So just far further south, huh? hop on my speeder, but it seems like every time I do, going to trigger automatic fights in this little area. Plus the fact that I want to keep stopping to pick up nodes. Nice when I can leave behind craters with bodies filled them in, with bodies filling them up. Scan the thing, please. Thank you. Hey, a group of smart black sons that didn't attack me just for walking by.
Care about holding the turf, not keeping it clean.
Kept it clean, we might not have dish piles. You thought of that? You guys are gonna come after me. Let's beat you to the punch, huh?
On your feet. To see slums like this when the people on the upper levels live just fine.
Gotten them all with the mortar blast instead of the electricity. And granted, either way it works. Now we got canisters everywhere, huh? Also got black sun everywhere. You come up with a gift, don't you? Yep. There's the node. There we go. Didn't realize you turned in anything until too late. That's what I get for not keeping an eye on my map for things like this. It's going to be the fastest route through here. Probably should go south first.
Here.
Ah. free stuff for me. What's in here? What did they have? A red case with unknown contents. Huh. Hell, hope it was worth it. So we go up and then down. Okay. Just two of them, huh? Other node since we're here. Ooh, a strong thing. Let's kill it. Yay, it's dead. Gave us his credits though. And that's what most of my slicing gets me, so, you know. Okay. Painful. Glad it wasn't me. What are you doing? You know, we could both scavenge, right? Return to Jaxo. I don't think we have a nearby warp point. So I'm not going to be able to do that this easily. Spawn? Huh. Yeah, people already respawned around here. Huh. Oh well. Guess that means I get more materials. If I'll ever use them, but I've got them. Anyone else have any ideas? Yeah, best way out. North, and then just keep me up. Kitty, not right now. I said not right now. You can wait 20 minutes. Ish.
On your feet.
We've had worse. Go kill that too. I want the material. There we go. A few less droids for the Black Suns. Okay, what you got for me?
Hey, you're back. Was the op a success? Were you able to neutralize the Trevoris?
This was kind of below me.
I can't believe they wasted my time on a mission like this.
Hey, sorry, Lieutenant Super Soldier. But not everyone is as good as you.
Damn right.
How about that red case? Were you able to grab whatever was inside?
Right here. Yeah. Don't want to lie about it.
The case contained this blaster, Sergeant.
I've never seen one quite like it. Must be some sort of new prototype. I'll take it back to headquarters
for analysis.
Yes, Kat,
I know you exist.
Maybe we can find out where Black Sun is getting their weapons. Guess we're through here then. It's been fun, Lieutenant. I hope we get to run together again sometime.
Dismissed.
Good day, Sergeant.
See you around, Lieutenant.
Come in, Lieutenant. This is General Garza. A situation has developed with the Senate, and I need your help.
Situation?
You need me to office Senator or something?
No, absolutely not. Tempting as it might be at times like this. Despite my best efforts, three members of the Senate Defense Committee have learned about Havoc Squad's defection, and they want to know the specifics. It's an informal inquiry for the time being, but you can bet it won't end there. I hate politics.
Ridiculous.
We don't have time for this, General.
I'm aware of that, Lieutenant, but we have no choice in the matter. The senators have asked that you appear in their office at the Senate Tower immediately to testify in the inquiry. I'm barred from influencing your testimony, but I will remind you that the more information that becomes public, the harder our job becomes.
I'll keep my mouth shut.
The senators won't get anything out of me.
How you testify is your business, Lieutenant. I could never, say, show wholehearted approval of your decision beforehand.
Government.
The senators are already waiting for you. Hurry back to the Senate Tower and try to get this over with quickly. Garza out.
As if we didn't have enough problems already.
Yeah, take that. That. And... don't think we need to hide her face. Not yet. Oh yeah, we need to go back to the tower. No reason to... no reason to take the long route. Aside from all the delicious, delicious nodes that are around. Yes, kitty, I know you're here. She's giving me this mean little glare. Cat does not like to be ignored. But what cat does, really?
Lieutenant, make yourself comfortable. On behalf of the Senate of the Galactic Republic, I want to thank you for appearing on such short notice for this informal inquiry.
Let's play along. Not like I had a choice.
You think I'd be here if I had any say in the matter?
I assure you, we will not hold you from your duties any longer than necessary, Lieutenant.
The purpose of this inquiry is to investigate the defection of several members of Republic Army Special Forces Squad Number 326, codenamed Havoc Squad, to the Sith Empire.
Now, you recently served in Havoc Squad on Ord Mantell, Lieutenant. Is that correct?
Don't waste my time.
You already know the answer. What are you asking me for?
It's a simple question, Lieutenant. Your hostility is unwarranted.
While serving on Ord Mantell, all of the members of Havoc Squad, excluding yourself, defected to the Sith Empire. Is that correct?
Yep.
Yes, Senator. My squad defected right in front of me.
Now, did Commander Tavis or any of the other members of Havoc Squad show signs of, say, instability? Anger? Frustration?
I don't know.
I'm afraid I don't know the people you're referring to all that closely, sir.
Lieutenant, you are lying to the Senate of the Galactic Republic.
Please, no one wants this to turn into a full-blown investigation. If you just answer honestly now, we can avoid all of that.
Lieutenant, let us speak hypothetically. Do you believe that anyone serving on Ord Mantell should have seen the situation coming?
Nope.
I don't think anyone could have seen this coming, sir.
Commander Tavis and the others must have been quite subtle indeed. I have one final question, Lieutenant. What connection, if any, exists between the events that occurred on Ando Prime and Havoc Squad's decision to defect?
Senator, I would remind you that the circumstances of Ando Prime are classified and occurred before the Lieutenant's involvement in Havoc Squad. You may ignore that question, Lieutenant.
Can I go now?
Are we through here?
Your part in this inquiry is concluded. You may return to your duties now.
Goodbye, Lieutenant.
Lousy government. Getting in my way. Oh, good, my boost hadn't worn off yet. Sure got a chance to refresh, though. That's not the right path. Trying to pet the kitty to appease the kitty. I'm not paying enough attention to where I'm going.
It's good you've arrived, Lieutenant. We have a great deal to discuss. First, let me congratulate you for your work on the Black Sun operation. You did well disabling that nerve gas. Also, that prototype blaster you confiscated will teach us a great deal about the Black Sun sources.
I should have kept it.
That blaster would have been a lot more useful in my hands than in a lab.
We don't know where that weapon came from, Lieutenant. Relying on it for your missions would be risky at best. And whatever you hope to achieve with your Senate testimony, you certainly didn't make my job any easier.
Deal with it.
This isn't about making your job easy, General.
The easier my job is, the easier your job is, Lieutenant. Try to keep that in mind. On to more pressing issues. My agents have discovered a vital new link to Havoc Squad here on Coruscant. Jack Carden, the founder of Havoc Squad and Commander Tavis's former mentor, has been spotted on the city's lower levels. He's serving as an officer in a local vigilante group.
We're just now learning this.
This guy's on Coruscant and we didn't know until now.
No one knew where Carden had gone. The man is a ghost. Carden resigned his commission and disappeared after the debacle on Ando Prime. If he's turned up now, it can't be a coincidence.
Okay, that's the second time this has been mentioned. What happened there?
Tavis told me that Ando Prime was the reason for Havoc's defection. What happened on that planet?
We sent Havoc to Ando Prime to cut off an Imperial offensive, but the enemy numbers were much bigger than Intel had led us to believe. When we tried to dispatch an extraction team, the Senate shut down the entire operation. We were causing an incident and breaching the peace.
Freaking government!
Bureaucrats. Havoc was left with no support and no way home. But in spite of insurmountable odds, Carden led Havoc out of there alive.
So he wasn't lying.
Havoc Squad really was betrayed by the Senate.
They were put in a terrible situation, Lieutenant, but that doesn't excuse their actions. Carden resigned as soon as he learned the truth, and Tavis took over the squad. They were never quite the same. What is important now is that we've discovered Jet Carden's location. I want you to bring him in at all costs.
You want him alive?
You don't want me to take Carden out?
If possible, I'd like you to capture Carden alive. If he is involved in the defection, he could provide us with invaluable intelligence. The vigilante group Carden is working with is called the Justicars Brigade. They control a large area of Coruscant's lower levels and are openly hostile to all outsiders.
And we put up with this.
Why do we tolerate these hostile groups here on Coruscant?
Most areas are safe. These sectors are the last pockets of lawlessness, aftermath of the Imperial attack. Our surveillance shows that Carden spends most of his time in the Justicar's main base. You will attempt to capture him there. Carden is a crucial link to Tavis and the rest of the Havoc traders, Lieutenant. Bring him in no matter what it takes.
He may not give me a choice.
If Carden presents a threat, I can't promise I won't kill him.
I understand. Just don't let your trigger finger get the better of you. I'm
That's
counting
one of my
on
best fingers.
Lieutenant. Dismissed.
The helmet back on for this. Recharge faster, please. Also hope if I ran the right direction. Let's actually go meet with Jack before I call this a video. so I can return to the cantina and drink away the memories of actually dealing with the Senate.
Open for business.
Stuttery ships. I'm about to be level 14. I also need to head down to that cantina area, and I believe that's where I can find my trainer. I mean, I've gained 2, and will probably gain a 3rd level here very shortly. I gotta have something. Did I start out at level 10 this time? I think I did. I think I actually started out at level 10 with this weekend's videos. Looks like we're gonna have to shoot some people. Just the cars or not. Aw, really? You ruined my fun there, Arg.
So a bunch of ex-soldiers take over the streets and call themselves Justicars.
There we go.
Like nut jobs to me.
Level 14. So that is going to be a heck of a run. I don't recall this place that well. I think I might have gotten enough. Wait, never enough. What am I saying? I would like to get to skill level 100-ish before I leave this planet. Don't think I can get there through this. I can go pick up that scavenge. Salvage, in this case. I may not be able to get to 100 before I leave this planet. And I didn't see the other one until I was headed away from it. Oh well. See if I can do something about where I need to go. Seven might possibly be getting close to actually being topped out there. Yeah, this one. Get my slicing up higher. I just gotta find more nodes. That's the way I need to go.
On your feet.
go. Now I get my stuff. So...
all of these docks and loading equipment. What the Chesticar's been up to.
I was about to walk right by that. Nothing? That was a ripoff. Weapon storage, huh? Also, salvage. Ah, now that's out of range. All it can do is get me more items.
Looks like a full-scale military base, not some hideout for vigilantes.
Still pick up the slicing, though. Oh, who am I kidding? I'll pick up everything. Yeah, I'm almost out of room. This. Take whatever's over here. Inventory full. Now, let's see. I should be able to turn all these into minor amounts of credits. There we go. Well, I guess I didn't actually take it, did I? Because I was full. Huh. Oh well. I am glad they upped the stack limit. Also just sell my junk here too.
Report your ailments.
You know, that's not as much as I thought it'd be.
You are fit for duty. Return to your post.
This would actually be a nice part of the city if the Justicars went around.
Take this. May just be small amounts of credits, but they. Well, that was three credit cases. May just be small amounts of credits, but they will add up by the end of everything. Three more credit cases. Huh. Said, may not be a ton of money. I'm not gonna turn my nose up at extra money. You actually gonna do that? Thank you. Wake up, come on. Darn it. You're all grouped up nicely for that.
Ah.
So, do I need to go down either path? Fair enough.
On your feet.
Was it, huh? There we go. Blowing all the things up.
You listen to me, Cardon. Helping you has already put my operation at risk. You will do exactly as I say, when I say, or
you'll what, Captain? I'm not one of your lock-stepping drones. This part of the op is mine. End of discussion.
How dare you?
Intruders!
Why am I holding
those
a pistol?
Floor, soldiers. Nice and slow.
Don't be stupid.
Unless you want to die, you should follow your own advice.
It's over, Cardon. You, the imps, Tavis, you're all going down.
Not gonna happen, soldier. Now drop that weapon before... Habit
Just
bands.
Shoot.
Is this a joke? No, no. You must be the new recruit Tavis told me about. So you survived after all. Can't say I'm surprised, honestly. Havoc always did recruit the best.
Last chance.
I don't want to hurt anyone, but I will.
You are a persistent soldier, I'll give you that. I'm impressed. I didn't think the old lady would send someone after me so quickly. After all these years, Garza still hasn't lost her edge.
What are you waiting for, Cardon? Kill the whelp! Or do you lack the true resolve to fight for the Empire?
My loyalty is to Tavis, not to your Empire and not to anyone else. You want the trooper dead? You take care of it. I don't kill good soldiers. I'm heading down to the works to make sure everything is prepped.
You aren't going anywhere.
Do yourself a favor and die now, soldier, before you get in any deeper over your head.
Why weren't we shooting?
Open fire, men!
Nice of you to group up for me. Very nice of you to group up for me. Why weren't we shooting at him, though?
Come in, Lieutenant. Is it my imagination, or were those Imperial soldiers you just fought?
You mean killed?
They were Imperial soldiers, sir. Now they're corpses.
Imperial soldiers in uniform operating on the lower levels of Coruscant. And Republic Security knows nothing about it? Incredible. We need to learn more about this link between the Justicars and the Empire. If they're hosting our enemies, they might have some useful information for us.
We should just wipe them out.
If the Justicars are hosting our enemies, they should be annihilated.
I agree, Lieutenant. But we should learn what we can before we grind these traitors into dust. Surveillance shows that the Justicars have their primary computer terminal in that base. Find the necessary access card and activate that computer terminal. My technicians can then slice in and uncover everything the Justicars and Imperials have been up to.
Hope they have records.
You really think the Justicars keep data on all of Cardin's activities?
As ex-military, I'm confident that they will have all their operations and personnel well documented. Just find the access card for the Justicars' primary computer terminal and activate it. My technicians will take care of the rest from here. Garza out.
So we aren't too far from this one. At least doesn't look like it. Yeah, we're like right next to it. Don't need to stop for extra fighting. We'll get plenty of that.
Ah!
Just a tiny bit too late with that. That couldn't have felt good. There we go. Decent amount of scavenging to be done around here, as I get stuck on crates for this much longer than normal episode. Can't even get to that one easily. Yes, I can. It's great of me, but you know. Didn't scan the droid. Oh well. Let's take that. Let's actually scan the droid and get the stuff off of it. Even though I'm not getting any skill points from it. Might as well keep taking the saves too. Since that's still giving me skill points anyway. Not much loot on him. Let's see. They should let us walk by. Granted, there's still a chance we could have just turned and killed you, but you know. Here. that. No loot. And
good work, Lieutenant. My technicians are accessing the Justicar files now. Patrol schedules, supply manifest, prisoner records. Ah, Cardon, you. I think we've found what we're looking for, Lieutenant. You have a new target.
What about him?
Saying the old man isn't my objective anymore?
Cardon is still an objective, but not your only objective. Cardon had the Justicars work with the Imperials to hijack and rebuild an abandoned Republic communications relay, down in an industrial area called the Works. Apparently, Tavis and his followers are using this relay to route all of their interplanetary communications. If we destroy it, the traitors will be completely cut off from one another.
Why would you risk a secret relay here?
Why would the traitors depend on equipment like this?
They obviously can't rely on Republic channels, and Imperial frequencies would be useless because we could trace their source. Tavis and his followers need this relay to keep us from overhearing their comm traffic. It's critical to their operations, which makes destroying it critical to ours. I'm sending Sergeant Matham to bring you the explosives you'll need to destroy the relay. He'll rendezvous with you shortly.
He better double time it.
If your guy doesn't get here fast, I'll never catch up to Cardon.
Matham is already en route, Lieutenant. You won't have to wait. One last thing. Cardon didn't seem to mesh with the Imperials. I don't think he's as convinced of their supremacy as his protégés are. You're sure to find him guarding that con relay. Kill him if you have to, Lieutenant, but try to persuade him to surrender peacefully first.
He's not really worth it.
With all the trouble Cardin's given me, I'd rather just off him.
Kill him if you have to, Lieutenant, but not just because you want to. He could still be a highly valuable source of intelligence. Cardon's only concern is the safety of the former Havoc members. He may not be loyal to us, but he isn't loyal to the Empire either. Convince him that's in the best interest of Tavis and the others for him to surrender. That's the best way to sway him.
Guess it's worth a try.
Can't hurt to see if Cardon will listen to reason.
I know Jack Cardon, Lieutenant. Convince him that surrendering is the only way that everyone comes out of this alive, and we'll have him. Now, hurry and rendezvous with Sergeant Matham. You'll need those explosives, regardless of what happens with Cardon. Good luck. Garza out.
Okay, so... because I am seriously over time here, and I'm level 15 now. Where do I actually need to go? Nowhere on the map, apparently. All the way in the works, huh? And how close can I get back to where... I can get right back here. But I think it's time for a little R&R. And gaining all the new powers I've missed out on so far. Already gone very heavily over time. I don't really want to make this a full double episode. So...
even Havoc Squad can learn from a veteran.
Full auto. Another grenade. Concussion charge, yeah. Hail of bolts. And trooper, we get even more grenades. Percent of maximum health. Yeah. So let's reorganize these. Heroic moment. Come on. Heroic moment could go here. The shield is a 2-minute cooldown for a shield. Go here. Go here. It's more of a stun than anything. So I do need to reorganize this. grab route and go up here. A whole bunch of different types of stuns and such. That is damage, pure and simple. Full auto. We'll have to see what happens. I need to put that down here, because that's useless to me for the most part. Put the other grenade here, that there. Halo bolts here. High impact bolt can go here. Sticky grenade needs to go here. All my AoEs. Put you down here. Along with full auto. No, full auto is the single assault. That's the double. Yeah. There we go. Okay. There we go. That's a little more organized for the moment. Let's go back to the cantina. And I will call this a finished episode. When we return, a slightly more open inventory, and we go meet up with Sergeant Mathen to, you know, get charges and such. Anyway, sorry this took a little longer than normal. Thank you all for joining me. I will see you back next weekend for more Old Republic fun. Later, all.